Hey, I am here, and I've been on Twitter the whole day, going back and forth, expressing myself in the best way possible. But I don't think it's doing enough justice because my heart is heavy. I'm carrying a lot of burden. I'm sure people, especially from Nigeria, with the thing that has happened recently with the interview that Bosola Dakolo granted, talking about her experience with the pastor, with Pastor Biodo of COSA. It all started with Timi Dakolo and him coming out, calling out pastors who have been doing this to their female members, and people were coming after him, they were coming against him. At that time, I didn't really understand what was going on. I didn't have the facts. I didn't know what was really up, you know, so I didn't say much. And then it happened again. And then all of a sudden, people just started attacking his wife. That got me even more confused. So I said, okay, something's happening here. Let me even find out, you know, what's going on. They started attacking her, calling her all sorts of names. And I still kept quiet because I'm like, it's very typical for someone to come out and say something, and the next thing people want to attack a member of his family or attack his personality or credibility. And then the interview came out. It was after midnight that I was alerted to what was going on, because I didn't know, I was doing something else. And someone showed me the thing. And I read it, then watched the full video. And I was shocked at the reaction. Not at the video, at the reaction of the video. Because this is what I've been talking about for so many years. Now let me start by saying to Timi Dakolo, congratulations, bro. I respect you from the bottom of my heart. I respect you, I congratulate you, and I applaud you for standing firm, for sticking to your truth, for standing by your words, and for supporting victims out there. Because when you came out, you didn't start talking on behalf of your wife. You didn't even mention her name. So let me just say thank you for being one man that can stand up, even in the face of adversity, to speak up for the rights of those who cannot speak for themselves. Because people seem to forget that when you are a role model, when you are a celebrity, when you are a household name, there's a responsibility that you carry. You have a job to do. It is your job to speak up for those who cannot speak up, because God placed some of us in a position that would give us that voice that others don't have, that would give us that courage, that boldness, knowing that people will listen to us. So you making that choice to use your voice to speak up for others, especially women and those young girls who are not strong enough to go on this battle, you making that decision makes you a hero to all of us. And let me say thank you, because you didn't make it all about your wife, because we didn't even know that your wife was affected by this. So let me say thank you to you, Timi Dakolo. And to Bosola Dakolo, I want to say God bless you for this courage that you have. God bless you for finally coming out and speaking up, speaking your own truth. Doesn't matter what anybody else has to say, it is your truth, and you have spoken your truth. Bosola, you have become a role model for a lot of other women out there who have been carrying this pain and this hurt for years, but were not able to. Some have tried, but were vilified, were crucified, were insulted. Some have tried to report to the authorities, but we know how Nigeria is. The rape culture in our nation is crazy. We've been talking about this for ages. We've been making films about it. The police will not do anything about it, nothing. So for you to come out, knowing what will come after this, to speak boldly, I applaud you and I stand with you. There are so many things I want to say now, but I know that at the right time, things will start coming out, because I'm sure people have seen my tweets and people have seen my husband's tweets as well. And we are not joking. We have had experiences with people who are supposed to be spiritual leaders, and in time, the stories will come out, but that's fine. I am talking about this issue now. I didn't want to post a picture of Bosola or Timi and just write, because sometimes people don't understand, people misunderstand your whatever you write. It can be misconstrued. That's why I'm doing a video personally, you know. First of all, the reason why I tweeted and said I stand with Bosola, because I believe her, It's because of some words that she used in her video that have been said to me directly. I'm not talking on behalf of anybody, I'm talking about me. When a spiritual leader tells you, don't worry, do this with me and my grace will cover you, my only saving grace was that I was not raped. But when a spiritual leader tells you, my grace will cover you, that word grace that they all, that most of them use, they use it, it's as if they have a meeting and they agree on what to use to pray on their victims, yeah? So that thing that she said is really true, because someone has said it to me before. Do this with me, sleep with me, and my grace will cover you. Who would you rather give your body to if not me? People like us, we have a special covering. That's what was said to me. We have a special covering. There's no other person that can give you that covering. I'm the one that's teaching you the word. I'm the one that understands the mind of God, not you. So don't worry. Whatever we do, you are covered. So when people came out and started attacking her, saying her story doesn't add up, I laughed. And there's one thing I want to say to everyone who thinks that this is unheard of, it's not possible, it's not true. All you need to do, go to Project Alert Nigeria, visit with Josephine Efachukwuma, the founder of Project Alert Nigeria. Let her open her records. Let her give you stories. Let her introduce you, because I've worked with her. Ketanji has worked with her. Let her give you stories. Let her even introduce you to victims. Young girls, when I say young girls, girls between the age of 6, 7, and 8 who were raped by their own biological fathers. I'm not talking about stepfather or teacher or friend. Who were raped by their own biological fathers. And these girls have been sodomized. If you don't know the meaning, check dictionary. What it means for a little girl to be sodomized. I met a mother and her child at an eatery, at a place in Ikeja. A fast food joint. I met with her and I was with Auntie Josephine Efachukwuma. And the girl's attitude, she was shaking. Anytime a man passes by her, she would do this. She is already at her tender age running away from men because of what her own father did to her that she has to live with for the rest of her life. And people are coming out to say, why has it taken this long for somebody to speak up? If you don't understand the meaning of trauma, just don't talk. Because women in Africa have been carrying burdens because society told us, raised us, put it in our heads that we can never say things like that. We are not allowed to speak. Then it's worse when the person who has done it to you is someone in a place of authority or someone who's a leader somewhere that has a following, knowing that that following can, do you know that most of these people, their strongest point is manipulation and brainwashing? The same way some of these people have brainwashed their followers, that even when their followers can see what is going on, they will still defend. It's the same brainwashing that these people use on their victims that make their victims feel powerless and can't talk. They can't come out and talk. They are afraid to talk. I cannot begin to tell you my own experiences or experiences of women that have opened up to me to tell me how many years they have carried this burden, to tell me how it has affected their marriages, how we try to suppress. That's why people say, oh, women, it seems women have memory loss faster than men. Why not? You don't understand the amount of suppression we have to do. We intentionally forget some of our experiences so that we don't think of it, because we can't even come to terms with what's happening. We are too ashamed to speak up because of society, because of victim shaming, because of the stigma, which is still happening right now in 2019, that somebody comes forward to speak her truth and people are still using this stupidity of stigma to just shame this woman for nothing. Do you know what it takes for somebody to sit down and grant an interview and talk about the most painful, the most intimate, I can't even begin to explain to you how painful it is to say something that you know your children can see. And then people come and say, her story doesn't add up. People come and say, why is she talking now? It's a lie. It's an attack. That's how somebody said it before. But because nobody wanted to listen to her, like somebody said, there was no celebrity backing her. But now, you people can see that it is happening over and over again. And there are more people coming out to say, it's happened to them as well. We have to stop. As a society, we have to stop making women feel like, oh, you can't talk about it. Oh, he's a pastor. Whether he's a pastor, whether he's a president, whether he's your father, whoever he is, a rapist is a rapist. And it's not just about Busola and Timmy. It's about every woman out there who's going through this and who does not have a voice and who does not know how to go about it or what to say. Now everybody is talking about it. It is your chance to get justice. It is your chance to get justice.